Hello, Facebook.
Hey, Periscope.
Hey, YouTube. Welcome to the L&D Show. I'm Lala.
I'm Devante.
We have a great show for you guys tonight. And may I just say, please forgive us for not showing up when we said we was going to show up.
I know, but accidents we have missed happen. You so much. Yes, scheduling has been completely off and everything.
Yes.
We have been trying our hardest.
And we both in sync tonight. Ooh, I didn't even know.
Exactly.
Look at that.
That's how it goes.
Hi.
That's how it goes. Hello to everyone that's coming in and joining the show
absolutely tonight.
Absolutely.
Hi, Simone.
Make sure y'all are bringing those comments,
topics. Absolutely.
So join.
Absolutely. Now listen, guys.
Pump those hearts.
Yes, pump those hearts. And make sure that you guys know that if my live goes out, you can always catch us on Devante's page, on his Periscope, which is Devante1990. Correct?
That's Devonte. Okay?
Hey, thank you, boo.
Pump those hearts, pump those likes.
This is
something funny. Pump those, those emojis and those laughs and things. So let us know what you're thinking. So we're definitely gonna get this show started on the road.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Okay, so let's talk about the show.
Yes.
Okay, so for you guys who do not know,
exactly, Lala had a phenomenal show. She
finally
got back to it. And it was great. She did a phenomenal show. Like, oh my God, I cannot wait to talk about it. She was great. She was stunning. And she's about to go on the road. We're about to take her on the road, y'all. Like, Simone was there.
Yes.
Well, her lovely wife to be and everything. I was there.
Yes.
Our cousins was there. Her family.
My dad was there. My dad was there. So it was amazing.
I'm not going to shade anybody, but we packed the joint out, okay? We packed the joint out.
We did.
We packed the joint. We had our own section in the house. Okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Like when let me put it this way. I love all of the performers.
Everybody did a phenomenal job. Absolutely.
But I have to definitely give, you know, shout outs to my cousins because I believe that she got the most money for everybody. So
I'm sorry. You're so silly.
She did. Like, y'all go and watch the show and everything. Like, if somebody got the entire show,
well, I haven't put it up on YouTube.
No, I mean like the entire show. Like, if somebody was able to get the entire show, you would see who's getting those bills.
Thank you so much. Well, for those of you who do not know, I performed Janet Jackson's What Have You Done For Me Lately, and If. Okay? Let me tell you about this. Okay, I suppose I have had two dancers from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then things happened to where they couldn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
So I was on my own. And so I was second guessing myself because I was always changing the set list. And anybody who has performed with me and knows me, I'm a perfectionist. Okay? So when it came to the set list, I was like, okay, I want to do Janet. I don't want to do Beyonce anymore. I want to do Janet, you know? And I said, okay, I'm a thick girl. Thick girls can move. Look at Lizzo. You know, Lizzo's doing out here for the, you know, thick girls and everything.
I absolutely love this Lizzo. So.
Yeah. And so... Thank you, baby. And so, I'm changing up the set list and everything, but the one song that stayed in the set list was always If.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I'm sorry, guys, this hair is like in my lip gloss. But as time got closer to the show, I was like, okay, this is a all-black club. No offense to anybody. But I was like, oh my God, this is like an all black club.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, I don't think they're going to take too kindly to If. You know, and people kept telling me, it's pride, Lala, it's pride.
Mm-hmm.
Do If, do it. And so I finally went my guts. I did it. I killed it. I practiced day in and day out. And it was...
I will say this. I was surprised to see that there were... Maybe because it was LGBT night, but I was surprised to see that it was a little bit of a mixed crowd there.
Me too.
So I was surprised to see that. But
me too.
Seeing as how it is broadcast as being primarily a, you know, predominantly black club and everything, I'm going to put this notice out there. we do need to do better by promoting our clubs, you know. I don't know if it's just our LGBT nights or something that's just not pecking out the house, but when we do go to white-owned clubs, they do seem to be getting the type of business that I would like to see in our black-owned clubs.
Well, I think Club Epic itself, they always pack it out with other events.
They do. I mean, they pack it out, like, maybe on their main screen nights as far as maybe was seen as main screen, like the straight nights and stuff like that. But I absolutely enjoyed myself, and I enjoyed, you know, the people who were there. Yeah. You know, the ones who interacted with us and all that good stuff.
Me too.
You know, I enjoyed the performers. The only thing that I believe was a letdown, outside of what we're going to talk about later, was just the crowd in general.
Right.
Because
right.
I was like, I really wanted to see people. I wanted to see.
Let me put it like this. The crowd, they were there, but the crowd was dead. And I was trying to do everything to get them, like, you know, bumping and everything. And I was, I'm trying to do What Have You Done For Me Lately. And then here comes If. And I'm like, oh my God. In my head, I'm thinking like, oh my God, this is it. This is it. I said, they're either going to hate it or they're going to love it. And please, God, do not let me fall. I did. And then I watched the video back. And when If comes on, you can hear people just like, oh my God, that's my song. Like, do it. Like, I'm like, oh my God, that's what's up. Mm-hmm. So I was really proud of myself for doing that. And I have to say that I second guessed myself a lot. Mm-hmm. And if I would have took out If, I think that would have been a bad performance, to be honest with you. I'm sorry, y'all. This hair, this fan is blowing, and this hair is like going directly to my lip gloss. It is.
Oh my gosh.
But I'm glad you enjoyed the show. I'm glad you could come and everything.
I definitely enjoyed, you know, yours, your, you know, your segment and everything, and I enjoyed all the other ones.
Yeah.
Now you know who's I probably enjoy, you know, just as much as yours, you know, the MC of the night.
Oh yeah, so. Yeah. Hey, how you doing?
Oh, look, cause he was flirting. He was flirting a little bit and everything.
Oh, well, like, there we go. That's that one.
I mean, I don't know if that was his part of, you know, his, you know, routine and everything. Probably get it, you know, a few more than ones or fives or whatever. But I mean.
Honey. Mm-mm. But yeah, I had a great time, and then I'm going to do it again soon, so that's going to be announced. So I'm already booked to do it again, so that's going to be announced very soon, guys.
Exactly. And for those of you who love to drink with us, and you know,
have a sip, honey, have a sip.
This is what we're drinking on tonight. Lala can say the name better than I can. I'm not going to lie. So
I don't even know if I said the name right. It's called Svedka or something like that.
So, yeah, Svedka. You know, mango pineapple.
I can mess up Svedka. A word, child.
Okay. So, I mean, so this is what we're drinking on tonight, Svedka. We probably need to probably chime in with Tia, because she probably can say it way better
than we can. Say it better.
Tia, our local bartender, she definitely can say it way better than
absolutely.
We can. But we're drinking a little Svedka tonight, so we're getting right with that.
Yeah, most
so,
definitely.
If you have that, you know, in your bar, in your home, and you want to sip with us, then that's what we're drinking on, the mango pineapple one. We may switch over to a little bit of, you know, the Amsterdam, you know, so we could switch to that tonight as well. So, yes. You know, on this show, we do love to get, you know, it's a tad bit tipsy, yes, because you never know which way this show could go.
Oh, gosh.
But especially on the nights of the premieres.
Yeah.
So.
Absolutely. Oh, speaking of the premieres. Okay, so we have a change, right?
Yes, we have a little bit of a change to the show. Instead of us going live on Saturday nights, we're going to be switching up just a tad bit. Instead of the shows going live on Saturdays and premiering on Wednesdays. We're going to now be going live on Tuesdays and premiering on Fridays. Alright, so that way your weeks can end off with a tad bit of a bang.
Yeah, absolutely.
Alright, so.
So we're still here.
We're still here.
We're still going strong. Exactly. The reason why we wasn't doing it, guys, because I was super tired with rehearsals and everything, and then you had your own thing
going on. It seemed like when she went into, you know, getting back with her show and everything, it seems like things for me, seeing it when I wanted to amp up as well, so it was just like, okay, well, you know what, we're just gonna take a small hiatus, you know, for that month and a half, and we're back.
So we're gonna have to balance it out, you know, because this is gonna be happening, shows are gonna be happening, and then my performances is gonna be happening, so we just have to balance it out and just come together and do the show, and not have to just tough it out.
Exactly, but we are here and we are strong.
Most definitely, most definitely. So, what did you wanted to say something about?
Well, let me tell a quick story about the actual night of the show. Okay, so I'm the type that I love to stick to my promises no matter what. No matter what it is that I'm going through. No matter, you know, good, bad, up, down, rain, sleet, or snow. Okay? So, since the moment that, you know, Lala and I walked into each other's lives. Now, we're cousins, but yes, you know, family sometimes discover each other later on in life. Yeah. So, I've never been able to actually see Lala perform. So I made the promise to her. I said, girl, if you ever get back on that stage, the night of your premiere, the night that you go back on stage, I will get you a car service. I want you to have a phenomenal night. I want you to be chauffeured. You know, you have to do it right. You have to do it large, you know. So I arranged for a car to pick her up from home, drive her to, you know, the venue and everything. So I reached out. I said I was not going to say the name of the place, you know, because I don't like putting business down.
Yeah.
But because of the way they responded to my review of them, I have no choice. Mm-hmm. So I have no choice. But so I arranged for the car. Now, I make sure I'm always on top of my game. I don't just do last minute things. So a good week and a half, 2 weeks in advance, I reached out to them and I said, hey, I want to, you know, reserve your, you know, your Stretch Suburban, you know, not the actual limo, but, you know, the actual Stretch Suburban, you know, the blacked out version. And I asked for two different locations because, you know, she wasn't for sure if she was going to get a hotel, you know, room for the night to get ready, or she was going to get picked up from her home. So I got the pricing and then I confirmed the location and I said, okay, this is the location that we're being picked up from, this location that we're going to, you know, we went back and forth through email and I thought we were all good. The day comes, I come to, you know, her house.
We're and I'm waiting. Already a mess.
We're going back and forth. Back and forth and everything. I was trying to have her get ready. I was trying to make sure I still look good and everything. It's and hot. We're both burning up, so we're trying to still look. I'm trying to still look good, not sweat and everything. Cause she's like, look, I'm losing weight, but I'm still big bone at the end of the day. So, you know.
But who was actually sweating, though?
She was the one who was sweating. And she had been in makeup since about 5.
Yes. So. I got makeup done at 4 o'clock that day. Thanks to Tori G. Hit her up on Facebook, guys. Tori Gambro. I love you, baby. Mwah. Thank you. So I had been in makeup since like 4 that day. And then I come home and everything. And I could not rehearse. That's why I was so terrified. So I was like, I'm in all this makeup. I cannot rehearse now because I don't want to sweat it off. So I'm sitting here and everything. And I'm trying to put on my wig. Mind you, I still had my crochets in. Okay? I still had my crochets and everything in.
That was like one snafu of the night.
Yes.
You know.
And so, thank God we didn't go to the hotel because I couldn't have did that.
Exactly.
Okay, so, basically, I'm going to get back to your story, too. This is like...
stories
and
stories.
This is like
all... stories within the stories.
Yeah, this is like all within. So, I'm sitting here, like, just panicking and everything. And so, I got my wig on and all that stuff. And the lady, she was like, yeah, that'll match your crochets and all that stuff. You can wear it on top of it. So, I'm like, okay, girl, I can do that. Child, as soon as I... got the wig. Actually, you know what? I didn't even put the wig on till that day. To that day, because
I was under the impression she had already put the wig on.
Because I had no, because I had been in like full blown rehearsals, and I was like, okay, I have to get this ready. I have to get this right. And then the DJ, she was like, you have to get this song. You have to get these songs submitted by a certain time. So I had to get everything final. And then on top of that, I had rehearsals and all that stuff. So I said, damn, it's almost Friday. Friday is here. You know, I still have the wig on, the mannequin and everything. Still haven't put it on. Still got my fox locks in and all that stuff. So. Child, I put that wig on top of that. Marquise, you came down too, and I said,
It ain't fitting right.
This is not gonna fit.
It ain't fitting this, right.
And you know, when the lady was telling me I could put it over it, I forgot that I was dancing.
Now here's the thing. She up here trying to do the Princess Leia bundles and everything. She trying to twist it up over here.
Yes,
I mean, she is just doing every which way.
I had my grandmother to like braid my crochets and everything up so I can get the wig on. Couldn't do it.
Nothing is going right. Couldn't Next thing it. I know, Lala done whipped out these scissors.
I said, cut it.
She like.
I said, Marquise, I gotta cut this.
So I gotta cut it.
And so Marquise was like, you gotta do what you gotta do, Lala. And so
at first I was like, are you sure?
I said yes.
Cause I'm thinking about the show, but I'm also thinking about, you know, her week after. Of going back to actual work, yes. And everything. Cause I'm like, are you sure? But I was like, girl, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah. And so I took the scissors and everything, grabbed the section, and I start cutting. And I said, oh gosh.
Cause first she had made a nip. And she was like, cause she had closed the scissors, but they didn't cut. But then when I see the nip, I said, girl, you gotta do what you gotta do. You ain't got no choice. You done nipped it. I said, especially the first two right there. I said, you done nipped them. I said, so now they y'all like, you know, they shaggy right there.
Right. And let me tell y'all, got to be glued. Is there a certain type of got to be glued for lace fronts? Because yeah. I got the got to be glued spiked.
So I have another good friend. And I got a phone with him. And I'm like, hey, now. When he picked up the phone, because we normally FaceTime. He picked the phone in black. I said, hey, Diana wrote something. No, I'm just doing hair. And I'm like, you doing hair? Yeah, baby, what's going on? I said, well, you know, Lala shows tonight and everything. I said, well, she got spike, got to be glued.
Yes.
And he said that, you know, you can use whatever got to be glued and it all worked the same.
Right.
But it wasn't until he came on camera, because I thought he was in the middle of doing something else, child.
Oh, honey.
Because when he was blacked out, I was like, oh, Lord, I didn't interrupt it. You know, him getting, you know, him serving his man or something. I'm like, oh, Lord.
Right.
Ooh-wee.
But yes, yeah, so I'm sitting there trying to put the got to be glued on and everything. I'm like, it's not sticking. And mind you, I know you have to do steps for it to stick. Mm-hmm. But my thing is, I wanted it to be tacked down right then and there.
Yeah, I asked her what's her blow dryer, because I've, you know.
Yeah.
If y'all have watched us, you know, throughout our years and everything, you've seen me with lace fronts and sew wings and all that stuff. And I knew the process. I've never done it myself, but I've seen the process done. So I was like, girl, where your blow dryer? You can't just slap that up there. You gotta paste it up there. Then you gotta let it. You gotta blow dry a little bit. You gotta paste it up again. You gotta make it tacky.
Right.
You gotta get it tacky. You gotta get that tacky.
Let me tell y'all though. You know, speaking of that, I didn't go with that. I went with the bobby pins. Okay. And so
she went old.
I was freaking out, guys. I was really freaking out. I had just cut my hair and everything. Just cut it. Like, just cut the locks off completely. Okay? I didn't even wash my hair, nothing.
Child, so when she cut it, pretty much she looked like Eve. She looked like Eve when Eve had the frosted tips. She looked like Eve when she had the frosted tips.
Honey, I was booked that night, honey. I had to be there, okay? I got paid for that.
The things we will go through to make sure can make the show make this coin.
I'm sitting here freaking out and everything, and I was like, I said, Marquise, I said, can you help me pin this down? Marquise said, no, la, la, I can do a lot of things. But pinning wigs down, I can't do it. I'm looking like, what are you here for? You know?
I'm here to do what I said I was going to do.
I got the wrong friend here.
I don't have to pin my wigs.
freaking out. Look, I was having a diva panic attack.
Look, I don't want to be no weeks, but she called grandma down.
Grandma came down.
When I tell you, grandma came down here and she worked that magic. Honey. Now, grandma said, man, when I pin a wig. Grandma said, I like to put the bobby pin in and not twist.
Oh, honey, and I felt it every time she twisted.
She said, do you feel it?
Ooh, I felt that look, thing, honey.
That's what grandma said. Grandma took that bobby pin and she said,
honey.
She took that bobby pin and
she's. Do you feel it? Child, what? That wig had never been so secure in his life, okay?
Look, she said, shake it.
Honey, you know, I should.
Paula said. Put another pin on this side.
I had to get those sides secured, child, because those sides were sticking up, and I had it half up too.
Grandma said that wig ain't going nowhere.
What? So to most of y'all who have not seen the video, I'm gonna put it on YouTube and all that stuff so y'all can see it. But
I love grandma. Grandma said
it was great.
Grandma said, if I'm not doing nothing else, I'm not a pin of wig.
It was great. And the whole time I'm doing, if I was like, oh my gosh, I said, do not let this wig flip up. Because if it does, I don't know what to do. And I had one of the queens in the back, Princess Mocha. I had her to pin the back of it because I was still pinning that thing in the back. I said, can you help me up a little bit? Can you pin the back of this wig for me? And she was like, pin the back of the wig. I said, yes, pin the back of the wig so it won't like fly up or anything. She was like, girl, you're fine. I said, Princess Mocha, I said, could you please pin the back of this wig up? Because I said, I'm going to be doing a lot of hair flipping. She said, you're going to be doing a lot of hair flipping. I said, yes, and I'm doing Janet Jackson. She said, oh, well, bring the pins here, baby.
Bring the pins here, baby.
Child, what?
And while we're going through all of this, like I said, the car is not here.
Yeah.
Because I'm outside, I'm looking, I said, Lala, I'm going to go outside and get some air, and I'm also looking for the car. So I've called the car service. I said, hey, you know, this is, you know, well, I'm using my whole name. I'm under this Marquise Neal, you know, I reserved, you know, your Suburban. It's not here yet. This man asked me for my name, and I told him my name. He said, I'm going to call you back. Instead of him calling me back, he sends me a text message. All your reservations were confirmed. I can have a car there on the way in about 10 minutes. Okay? Then, you know, he was like, okay, I can have a car there at 10:10. Okay? Get him here. I need him here because I reserved it.
Right.
He switched that from, instead of the Suburban, okay, how about I do a limo two-way? Now, anybody who reads the word two-way, that means going and coming, right?
Right.
So, he said, I can do a limo for $100 two-way. I'll take it. Now, the original price I was going to pay was $195. I'm like, cool. You don't save me $95. I'm definitely not going to turn out a limo for $100.
Yeah,
absolutely. Cool. Now, I'm reading the text message again, and then it said two-way, and I think he misspelled Uber. He said Uber back. I was like, wait a second. So when the driver arrived, first he called me and said, hey, I'm outside the hotel, and then the owner apparently followed that up with, hey, he's outside, he doesn't have much time. Wait a second now. Don't rush me. I am paying you. So,
and this is why we were at the house.
This is why we're at the house.
Not at the club. We
were
at the house.
We're at the house.
I was still having my freak out at this time. He was outside.
I'm outside. I'm trying to still help Lala. I'm down here with grandma and everything. So I'm on the phone with the driver and I'm like, no, why are you at the hotel? I said, my email said for you to meet at the house. I'm not about to get the address, so y'all stop trying to listen up so closely and everything, because you're not about to get the email. You're not about to get the address of the house. So
yeah, absolutely.
I said, the house, you know. And he said, oh my God, I'm so sorry and everything. So, you know, he finally gets to the house, which, mind you, he pulls around the corner with his goddamn tail up, with the trunk up. I think he has a spooler or something. And
your mama said she felt good.
Oh, Lord. Did. Yeah, she even drank it, probably. She out there partying with the family.
Go ahead, Zoe.
But, good, honey. So, he gets here, and I show him the text message. I'm like, hey, this is for both ways, right? Because I think I may have misread, or it might be some miscommunication or something. He said, no, I'm supposed to just take you. And I was like, okay, so is there going to be like another car picking us up or something? I'm like, look, I don't mind paying the original price because I've had this conversation with other people and they was like, well, you know, at the end of the day, you got to be humble. I'm like, it's not about being humble. I'm humble at the end of the day because we've been out to clubs, we've been out to bars and venues, stuff like that, and we've driven ourselves. Mm-hmm. So it does not matter about that. We've taken Ubers, we've taken Lyfts, you know, we walked. So this is not about being humble. This is not about being, you know, above and beyond, none of that stuff. It's about, you know, the principle of the matter. It does not look right to show up in a limo when you've arranged it for both ways and then you Uber back home. I have no issues with Uber or Lyft, but how does it look for me to show up in a scratch limo?
Yeah.
And then take a chance on getting a Honda Civic to pick me up from the club.
Yeah, because I didn't like that. Because when you told me that the limo wasn't going to pick us up, I said, what'd you say? I was like, no, no, no. What'd you say? You know, honey, I want to start something fabulous.
I'm okay. Like...
And guess what? That damn limo. Everybody see me pull off, honey. Because shout, when we pulled up, wasn't nobody out there.
Look.
I said...
That's right. I'm like... There was a few people outside when we pulled up. Like I said, it's not really about being supposedly seen because I just wanted Lala to be chauffeured to and from. I wanted to be seen, but I also wanted her to be chauffeured to and from. That's the main thing.
You did a great job.
You know.
After, you know, I calmed down, after everything was over with, I was like, my cousin actually got me a limo.
Yeah.
Not knowing that wasn't in the plans, that we supposed to have had a Suburban.
Mm-hmm.
But when I went outside in my heels, I seen a limo.
Mm-hmm.
And in my head, I said, bitch, don't you trip. I said, don't you trip, bitch. What you doing?
No. So, you know, I'm messaging, you know, the owner of the company who apparently is in Florida. So I'm like, why are you in Florida? And didn't leave somebody else in charge of the day-to-day. If you're on vacation, be on vacation.
Absolutely.
So, normally I don't do internet reviews or, you know, like, what is it? York or whatever it is. But I did a Google review for the company. So, I'm going to reach out a review really fast. Then I'm going to tell y'all the company. This is the reason why I will never use them again. Primarily because they told me never to come back.
Really?
Let me tell you. So, I gave them 2 stars. The reason why I gave them 2 stars is because I enjoyed the first time I used them. So, this is what I said. I said, I've used this company before and was very satisfied. I requested a Suburban and got a Mercedes, so I was beyond satisfied. Last Saturday, I started the process of reserving the Suburban again. Went through all the motions and back and forth of getting the details together. I was asked for my destination. I responded and no email was sent back. I assumed my reservation was good. The date of my event came, no car. I called the company, which turned into back and forth texts. Was told my reservation wasn't confirmed. I would give some leeway on the company accommodating me with a limo for a deal price. However, it was for a one-way trip, and I needed and wanted a car to take me to and back home from the event. I wasn't satisfied this time around. I'm going to have to soul search to see if I ever want to use GSP again.
Mm.
The owner actually responded back, but instead of responding back in a professional manner, this is how he responded. Your reservation was never confirmed, or you would have received a confirmation email, along with another email with driver info. At last minute, we gave you a limo for a Suburban price to be nice and help you out, and you give us a bad review. Just goes, I guess you just get meant to say goes to show that you can't please everyone. Will be no need to contact us again, but thanks for the input.
What? Damn.
And this was GSP Limo.
Wow.
So like I said, the first time around, because a Suburban and a Mercedes is far in between. So I'm like, okay, y'all wasn't able to give me the Suburban, but you gave me a Mercedes? Cool. I'm not disappointed at all. I'll recommend anyone to use your company. Yes. But this time around, and like I said, they took me, brought me back and everything to the event that I had going on. But this time around, one, you didn't show up when I needed you. Then you're rushing me in the process. Mm-hmm. You wanted to give me a one-way trip. You wanted me to Uber back home. And then when I do a review, instead of you saying, oh, that's our fault, you know, maybe in the future we can, you know, do better, or we can give you a good, you know, deal on, you know, your reservation or something, you just go out and attack me and say, no need to come back again.
Mm. Wow. Wow.
That is so unprofessional.
That is.
So unprofessional. You want to keep business because at the end of the day, you are a mom and pop company. Mm. And yes, you do have the leeway to say never to come back. But if Mickey D's, Burger King, Wendy's, Bilo, any of these major chains said, hey, I need to come back, they would not have the business that they have today. I promise you they wouldn't.
Wow.
And if you look around the world, they have closed stores down. And that's because some of these places cannot keep business. Burger King is one example. Burger King, sometimes they only get bursts of business. Mm. KFC is another place. They get bursts of business. Hardee's, they get bursts of business. It's all about how they market, how they present themselves, and how their product is.
Wow. Well, speaking of how people present themselves in business, and good business, and bad business, and marketing, let's talk about Summer Walker.
Exactly.
All right, so me personally, I haven't really listened to Summer Walker's music.
I don't think I have.
But everybody seems to love Summer Walker. And I did not know that she suffered from social anxiety. I didn't know that she suffered from that. There we go. As soon as we talk about Summer Walker.
Lord have mercy.
Jeez. So, anywho, I didn't know that she suffered from social anxiety. So, she's actually canceling 20 dates.
She has 9 and she's only really going to do her major cities.
Which is Boston, Chicago,
Atlanta,
and New York.
New York City.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's only going to do that. And, you know, my thing with that is, okay, so you know that when you become an artist, mm-hmm. you're going to have to go on tour. Mm-hmm. You're going to have to do concerts. People are going to want to meet and greet you. You're going to have to do those. People pay money for your tickets, and then all of a sudden you cancel on them just because you have social anxiety.
There are medications and things out there for that. So, I mean, for me, because for the most part, growing up, I was more of what we would all probably call a loner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm not going to say recluse, but I did prefer to be by myself.
Right.
I didn't really prefer to be around crowds and things of that nature. I definitely, to this day, really do not like being touched.
Mm.
You know. And if you do touch me, it doesn't matter how clean you are, how dirty you are, I probably am going to go and wash myself off. Not necessarily like full on shower, but I am going probably going to go wash my hands. Wash my hands, wash my face, and all that stuff. Right. You know, and I am in healthcare. You know, that's my main job at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. My main source of income is healthcare.
Yeah.
After each patient, and it is just a sanitary thing, but it's not just because of me leaving a patient to go to the next patient. It's right. because of me having OCD, my personality, and it just makes me feel better and more wholesome after being with people at the end of the day, I go and I quote unquote sanitize myself. But when it comes down to Summer Walker. My apologies. But Sunny. Let me write Gary.
I don't know her.
But Summer, when it comes down to her, if your anxiety is to the point to where you have to cancel that many dates, it's probably best that you find the nearest, you know, probably not neurosurgeon, but the nearest psychologist or, you know, neurospecialist. Get some type of medication. Talk to some people to help you deal with it. Because,
well, I think I have it.
I mean,
because I don't even go out with you guys. Because I feel like people are going to talk about me. I'll be wanting to dance and everything. And it's like, damn.
But,
like, if I get out there. I think
yours is different than hers. Yours is more along the lines of a self-image thing and not the being touched, being groped, or, you know, because she said she's an empath. And she said that when she doesn't want to hug, she said she doesn't want to be hugged because that many people hugging and touching her and embracing her,
with that energy,
it will kill her. Mm-hmm. You know, now, I myself, you know, am an empath, but I am very particular about the people that I choose to embrace, you know. And people who have come into contact with me say that it's very easy to talk to me and they feel like they can relate to me or they can open up to me. And that's the thing about being an empath. Mm-hmm. We are easy to open up to. Mm-hmm. So when people come around us and everything, they just automatically be like, oh my God, I feel like I can talk to you. I feel like I can, you know, be myself around you. And that could be the most evil spirited person, and all of a sudden they're just yin. And they're like, I've never talked to nobody like this before in my life.
Damn.
You ever noticed that?
Yes. But you like,
have you ever noticed that though? They're like, I've never talked to nobody like this before in my life. But they're just like,
we be listening to,
and they be like,
but you know,
they feel good getting off my chest.
We listen from the heart too, because sometimes they can go so deep, and you know that they're opening up some wounds they needed to, you know, get off the chest. So we listen, and you know, we don't tell anybody about that. At least I don't talk about other people's problems where they tell me or stuff like that. But
the thing about being an empath,
is
that it's sometimes hard to carry so many burdens around. So that's the reason why some of us choose to only come into contact
with. Then they always ask us, like, what should I do? And it's like, damn, why are you putting it on me? Like, I don't know. Go talk to them or something. Write them.
Being an empath, we cannot release the stress the way that other people can.
Right. Absolutely.
Because we harbor it. We're the strong person for a lot of other people. So I get it where, you know, I'm about to call her Sonya again. Summer is coming from, where she says that much transfers of energy will kill her.
Right.
Because.
Sorry, guys. Hold on.
I can seriously. Oh my God.
When's it done?
Sure, give us like 1 minute, and we will let you join in, because we are actually running off the show in just a few minutes. So I definitely get it where, you know, she says that much transfer of energy can definitely kill her. You know, if this may be a figure of speech or thing, but it literally overwhelms you to the point of being like, I just can't take any more, because I have seriously had my breaking point to where I'm just like riding down the road and out of nowhere I'm just like, oh my gosh, and break out crying. And people don't understand it. Like, you don't know how we feel. Like, But we also had those moments where we're just the strong person. We have somebody who wants to join. So
okay, sure, let them join.
Yeah.
Guys, if y'all are, we're back, but if you're just not tuning back in, we are talking about Summer Walker and her social anxiety. Hello.
Hello, hi, can you hear me?
Yes, how are you doing? You said you're from London?
How y'all doing?
Good.
I'm from London, by the way. Where you guys from?
We're from, well, South Carolina, USA. So, do you live in London right now, correct?
So, how's the USA compared to the USA?
For the most part, yeah. I mean, we love it. I don't think I would live anywhere else. I want to visit other places, but I don't think I would live anywhere else.
You know that the LGBT community is very strong.
Huh?
Pardon?
What'd you say again?
The gay community has to be very strong.
Yes. It's definitely growing and...
On our zebra crossings. You know on our zebra crossings we have the gay pride flag.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. Is there pride there right now or something?
Yeah, we celebrate gay pride.
Awesome.
Did y'all just celebrate gay pride?
Yeah.
See... I think New York Pride is coming up soon here, isn't it?
I think so.
And I think, yeah, New York Pride is coming up soon here. We just had Atlanta Pride. So we have a lot of different prides around the country here. So
right.
It just depends on which time of the year it is here. So,
well, is there something that you wanted to talk about?
Do you have a particular topic that you want to talk about?
I can't hear you.
Did you have a particular topic that you had in mind?
Not really. I mean,
okay.
Bring up a topic
and discuss it. Oh, no, honey. We don't have that much time, but thank you so much for calling in.
Yeah, normally when you call in to our show, we have a topic. You have to bring forth a topic, and we'll talk about it with you.
Nah, I just not sucking dick
up. Huh? What'd you say?
Anywho, oh, we got time for that. Okay, listen, we don't got time for that, honey. Okay, so Summer Walker has social anxiety. We said that if she got into the business, she knew what she was getting herself into. This is not the place for her. Okay,
true.
All right, we all suffer from it. Some of us, I would say, we all suffer from it, but some of us have anxieties.
Yeah,
different types of anxieties, and we know
we
what
all
we can
deal
get
with
into,
it in a different
what we
way.
Can't get into. Her manager should have been on the spot to say, "Hey, are you okay to do this tour?" Should have checked in with her instead of putting her out there. Okay.
I mean, I would definitely say because pretty much she said as long as she's behind the music and everything, she's good. But maybe before she started the touring process, it should have definitely been a process of getting her mind strong, her physically strong enough to do it, you know, prior to it, because
absolutely
she could have definitely been doing the music and doing the albums and everything way before she actually did tour dates.
I agree.
You know, because she could have had like three albums out
she
before.
She said she's going to make music, you know.
Yeah.
And she did say that this was going to be her first and her last album.
I thought she said first and last tour.
Well, she said first and last, at least she said first and last album as well, too. But now she's changing it up and she's saying that this is going to be her last tour.
Yeah, I don't recall the first
she said,
last
she said
album,
she
but
wanted,
I do know
she said first and last tour. Initially, she said she wanted to retire from music altogether. She said she wanted to retire. I'm looking like, girl, you just that got here. What the hell? But that's
because there are so many people. There are so many people out there who want to be in her position.
Some people are like that. They get into the music industry. They have success. They may have one hit or so, two hits. Just need the money or whatever, and call it quits. That's it. I really don't want to do this. This was just for fun. Like, and then she became a sensation. Like. Over a year, and that was just like that. She took off, and she don't know how to handle it.
So, now, what genre of music is she in?
She's more into the R&B field.
Okay.
I wouldn't say neo-soul, but okay. It's R&B. Like,
I'm going to have to actually listen to her music.
Because I haven't really like, heard her music like that. But everybody seems to love her. Like, especially the ladies. They seem to love her. Mm-hmm. They seem to relate to her and everything and all that good stuff. So, okay. Let's talk about this really quick, guys. We was going to shoot for 45 minutes, but we could probably go over that. Mm-hmm. It's just going to take, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
So, okay. Is the breakup official? Once the block button has been hit. Do you think it's official once the block button has been hit?
See, the thing with the block button for me, not necessarily for me, but I would say like this because the block button in this generation is unique. You can hit the block button after you've broken up with someone and then they'll unblock you a few days later and be like, hey, what you doing?
I don't like that.
You can be friends with someone and they'll block you and pretend like they never did it. And be like, oh, I know what you're talking about, you know, and they just wanted peace and quiet. They just wanted not to hear from you or whatever, you know, their phone was off, you know, so many different things.
I'm still blocked by my ex. My ex still got me blocked at
it. I mean, because there's someone who was supposed to be in my life, you know, who I wanted to be in my life, and they blocked me across the board.
Damn.
You know, but now they're trying hard, when I say hard, to get me back in their life.
Mm.
And I'm like,
no, because I'll block someone, then unblock them and tell them I did it.
But you know, for me, I don't do block.
Because, you know, once you block someone, that's basically a friend of them too at the same time. Mm-hmm. So, you know. I've done it.
That's what I said, but
I've done it.
For
I've
me, I don't do
anger.
Block.
I've done it out of anger.
Because like I feel like like not blocking you is so much more harsh.
Hi, Travis. Is that Travis? Yeah, Travis.
I feel like not blocking you is so much more harsh than blocking you because you know for a fact that I am intentionally ignoring you.
Yeah,
I've seen all your phone calls. I've seen all your text messages. I've seen all your DMs. Mm. I've seen all your Snap posts, your Facebook messengers, Instagram, Twitter. I've seen it all.
Simone and for says, those, I stop talking to a person, period, and ignore all calls.
That's what I said. That's me. Because I feel like it's so much more harsh, and it hurts you on a deeper level than just blocking you. Mm. See, when you've been blocked, someone automatically knows on that first attempt, oh, absolutely. Okay. But when they've called, they've texted, then they can guess, oh, okay, maybe they didn't get it.
Mm.
But after weeks and months and years or however long they choose to continue to try, then they finally get to a point to, I think he's ignoring me. I think she's ignoring me. Also, that's what they're going to do. And they have to seriously go through
she petty.
All those emotions and be like, oh, so that's what you want to do? Oh my God, please reach out to me. Please call me.
Simone says, I just blocked to be aggravating. I believe it too.
But see, there's a show called Married to Medicine. Absolutely. I don't know if anybody's ever seen it, but there's this couple. I don't know if their divorce is official or not, but there's this couple, their names are Quan and Dr. G. They were married. And Quan would seriously block her husband and be like, I don't want to talk to you right now. I don't want to talk to you. Doctor, I'm blocking you.
Yeah.
You're blocked. It would block him for like 3 days. And then unblock him when she was ready to talk to him. Like, they would talk at home, but when they were not in the house, he would be on block. That's what I said. The block button on nowadays is seriously unique. It just depends on your relationship. Because I'm like, this couple is seriously married, but she will block her own husband. So,
mm-mm.
It's unique to me. But as far as breakups go, it just depends on who's actually blocking you. It might be official to some people, but to other people, like I said, they might block you. And then a month later, I'm blocking like, hey, what's up? I've been thinking about you. So like I said, I had somebody who seriously I wanted to be with. I found out about their double life and everything. They tried to pin everything on me, and I was like, you know what? I'm done with this. I'm done with the games and everything. I walked away. They, like I said, they tried to put everything on me. They end up blocking me across the board, and then next thing I know, they're trying to get back into my life by unblocking me. I was like,
Travis said he loved that show. And Simone said, Quad and Dr. G are divorced.
They're finally divorced. But you remember when she would block Kim, right? She would seriously block Dr. G.
Just petty.
And they were married.
Just petty. So guys, make sure you guys throw your topics or your comments down below. And comment on that topic, okay, baby? All right, next in line, we have Tokyo Toni, who was on Dish Nation. And she dropped a whole lot of tea. Don't know if it's true or not. But she say that she has been with bisexual men, and she would not mind having a threesome with a bisexual man and another man, and watching him get pounded by the other man, per se. So, Tokyo Toni says she's a freak. She says she would even date a transgender because it's, you know,
transgender woman.
Yeah, she dated a transgender woman, but she said that we are cute. She said that cute on the eyes and everything, and we have, most of us have the penises and all that stuff. So she's like, we're the perfect package. So I said, hey, but I wouldn't do that though. Not Tokyo Toni.
Would it have to be a transgender woman who wants to be with a woman?
Correct. And there's some of us who are like that. There's some of us who are actually, I call it lesbian still, because we're women, but then you dating a woman. I call that a lesbian. And I've known people.
So it'll have to be like a Caitlyn Jenner.
I guess. Fun times. Really, Travis? I bet your ass have on nasty coot. I'm nasty, honey. But would you ever date a bisexual guy who invited you into the bedroom with his
girlfriend? I don't do threesomes when I don't do women. I've been invited several. When I say several, I do mean several. And it's like those invitations are endless.
What invitations?
The invitations for the threesomes, the invitations for the, my wife, I want to see you do this with my wife.
Really?
Yes!
So you have actually been invited to a cocoa session?
Yes!
Oh, do it and record it. I got it.
No!
I'm a sexologist and I have got
no.
to do this, okay?
No, sir. No, yes. Ma'am. No.
Yes. If the dude was fine, would you do it then?
Oh, it don't matter how fine you look.
Because my thing is, oh, thank you, baby. Thank you. My thing is, okay, I have to be open, all right? I have to be open. If a bisexual guy invited me to the bedroom with him and his girl, I couldn't do anything with his woman.
But that's what.
But kiss her.
That's what.
While she's getting fucked by him.
That's what. I can't. But no, he wants. He probably wants to see you do way more. He probably wants to see you go down there.
I'm not licking. I'm not kissing the cat. I'm not doing anything. Kissing the lips. Okay.
We got. We've had London in the house. We've had Spain in the house.
Hi. Yes, honey. Yes, I think that's why some of these women be mad when they. Men cheat with transgender because they look better than us. Really, Paris? Than us women. I am proud to say it. Hell, I take lessons from them, from dressing to the makeup. Oh, dang! From dressing to the makeup. Girl! Paris, you're in trouble.
Speaking of the dressing, I'm going to jump topics just for one moment because I had a topic that I want to talk about before we end the show.
Yes, I'm sorry. Yes.
So, I had a date. And I want to see how everybody feels about this and everything. Because first impressions do really matter.
Oh, yes, yes.
First impressions really, truly, truly do matter. So, this man has kept my coat.
He what now?
He kept my coat.
He He kept your coat?
I actually more or less gave it to him because I didn't want the coat back.
Can I have a little bit more drink? Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. I got it.
No. Actually, use this when it's already pre-mixed.
Oh, okay, cool.
So, and you feel my talking myself too. Okay. But I'm going to need it. So, I was chatting with this, you know, guy and everything. And, you know, the conversation was pretty great. You know, life goals and everything. Wanting to get a house, buy a new car and all that good stuff. I'm like, okay, that's wonderful. Two jobs. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when you find somebody like that, wanna buy a house. I'm trying to get a new car. You know, I'm working two jobs. That sounds amazing. So, he wanted to meet up. I said, okay, that sounds good. We can meet up. Tell me why I go to pick this man up. And he seriously walks out the house, and all he has on is a t-shirt, some joggers, and some slides.
T-shirt, joggers, and slides.
Slides.
For the first date?
For the first date.
Huh.
And I'm like, okay, I know we're just chilling, but just roll with it. Just roll with Devontae. Just roll with it. Just roll with it. Just roll with it. Okay, just stop being judgmental. Stop being judgmental. So, this is the thing about the gay community. I know this LGBT chat. I can't really speak for the trans community. I can't speak for the lesbian community or the bi community or anything like that. But the gay community has this big thing about masculine men, and it kills me. That's why I cannot stand playing into these roles and these titles, because I believe we're all just us. But so he opens my door and he was like, "Friend, hey friend,
oh,
how you doing, friend?" I was like, "Hey, how you doing?"
So he called you friend.
Friend.
Okay.
I was like, "Hey, how you doing?" He gets in, and you know, like I said, first impressions do matter. So he asked me if I could drop his friend off somewhere. I'm trying to be nice. I dropped his friend off somewhere.
Wait a minute. Hold on. You dropped his friend off?
His friend girl off somewhere.
Hell no.
I dropped his friend girl off somewhere.
You don't do that on the first date.
I'm like, I'm trying to be nice. Okay. Let's just see where this goes. Okay. So, I noticed his speech. I'm like, maybe he just talks like this. So you know when you looking down the road before you make your turn, I look this way, which is not facing his direction. I look to my left. When I whip my head back around, he done pulled the bottle out of his fanny pack.
Oh!
Then took a swig and then I offered it to me. I said, oh no, I'm good. First of all, I'm not about to be drinking in my car. And I'm especially not about to be doing it in Spartanburg. Well, I might get caught by the police.
The hell? So, he had been drinking?
He had been drinking prior to us hanging out. And he's drinking in my car.
Oh, no.
So,
after, you know, I had dropped a friend off.
I'm like, okay. Mm-mm. Scripe. I had told him prior to us meeting up, I need to go get a haircut. Mm-hmm. He said he needed to get one too because he had not yet gotten one. So that's what we're heading to, is to get haircuts. We're at the barbershop. I tried to pass judgment on the barbershop because, you know, hey, for all I know, this barber could be great. I'm watching her cut hair and everything. So, okay, she knows she's doing a great job. So I'm going to go ahead and give her a chance.
Absolutely.
Child, she done hooked me up. Mm. But she done asked me, is he intoxicated? Because he's going back and forth with the barber. Mm. He done touched his clippers. He's cursing him out. He's using his brush and everything. And I'm like, she's like, how are y'all talking? I said this. I said, we've been talking for like a week or two. I said, but this is my first time actually physically meeting him. She said, okay, because, you know, he don't normally act like this. And I'm like, okay, something definitely ain't right. So, you know how when you send your little 911 text or something, you know, you hit your friends up. You're like, okay, yeah. Look. I done sent one of my best friends I might need a 911 text before we got to the barbershop. I'm trying to do it to where he don't see me. But the whole time we actually sitting waiting to be serviced and everything at the barbershop, he all up in my face and he talking, he know he doing one of these numbers and all that stuff, and I'm just like, okay, I can't text while he all up in my face.
Right.
So we left the barbershop. Now we had made an agreement because I had texted him. I was like, before we even met up, I said, hey, does the barbershop accept cards? Because I didn't have cash on me. He said, yeah. So that let me know I need to stop and get some cash. Mm-hmm. We get there and apparently they don't accept cards. But luckily, the barber who did mine accepted cash out. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I could just use that. So then he was like, oh, no, I'll just pay for yours. You can pay for the food. I thought we had an understanding. Oh, man. I ended up paying for my own hair, you know, my haircut or my shape up. Which was fine by me. So when we left, we had agreed to go to Texas Roadhouse. I'm driving there. I'm about to turn. He said, where you going? Texas Roadhouse? Oh, no. Since you didn't pay for my food. Mm. I mean, since you didn't pay for my my haircut and everything, we're going somewhere. So I'm a cheap bitch. Okay.
See, I didn't go to Texas Roadhouse.
No, we didn't. Thank you. So, he works for a manufacturing company that makes parts for BMW. And then his other job is KFC. So, I was like, okay, since you work for KFC, I guess we will not go there. Hell no. But you know what? Since their food might be fresh and everything, so we can go there. I'm in the lane all the way over here. KFC is all the way over here. And I'm like, he seriously done jumped across my seat, lit my window down. Hey! I'm like,
he did it for real. Who's trying to get his attention?
He tried to get the people's attention that's in the lanes over here. And I'm like,
so y'all can get over.
I try to be. So we can get over. And I'm like,
To KFC.
To KFC. And I'm like, it's not that serious. I said, there's like several restaurants up the road. We can go up the road, come back down. I'm like, it's not that. Like, for real? Ooh. This is my car. You're not even insured on the car. I'm like, I drive a Yukon. This is not like, you know, a little Honda. You know, it's not like a Camry. I have nothing against none of these cars, but I don't drive a small car. If I whip my car out there and I hit another small car, I might take their life. I might turn my car over because it's top heavy.
What do you say?
Like, hey! I'm like, child.
You know I would have been hollering.
We got somebody who want to enter chat real fast.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, I think I may have missed you. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
But, so we get to KFC. I go wash my hands. And I come out. He's over the counter talking to the employees in the back.
Uh-uh.
And I'm like, okay. Are you serious? So, then he goes to the person at the cash register. He was like, he tried to tell me that I'm getting... He goes to the cash register and tells me that I'm going to get chicken tenders. I said, I don't want chicken tenders. But that's all that got up. I was like, he asked the cash register. He said, which I got up? He said, we got everything except for a chicken pot pie. I said, okay, cool. Let me get the big box. Let me get original crispy. I done told him everything I want. And he's like, okay, let me get chicken tenders. You want chicken tenders, but I don't want chicken tenders. He just tried to tell me three times, I'm going to get chicken tenders. I don't want chicken tenders. Dude, are you okay? So, we wait maybe 3 minutes for our food. He done got pissed off.
No name dropping on this show.
No name dropping, no. We done waited 3 minutes for our food. He done got pissed off. See, that's why I don't like coming here and everything. I'm like, it's been 3 minutes. We got like 40 people in front of us waiting for food. And some family ordered like 60 pieces of chicken.
Damn.
Like, for real. Like, it was like a family of like 20 that ordered like 60 pieces of chicken. So, dude, calm down. So, one of my best friends didn't respond back. So, I text another best friend. I said, hey, call me right now. Say it's an emergency. And you need me to come home like right now. She gonna text me back why. Just do it. Just do what she talking about. So, B, I called, but you got to narrate yourself. So she got on the phone. I said, hey, what's going on? What? You in the hospital? Oh my God, what happened? I'm on the way. He arguing with the people behind the counter and everything, but then he done try to get a job at the same time.
What?
I'm like, how you gonna argue with them, but then try to get a job? So I'm like, I'll work the KFC on the other side of town, but I'm not gonna work at this one.
Are you okay?
So of course, when we finally leave, because I done told him I had an emergency, but he was like, okay, well, whatever, you take me home.
How you gonna try to get an attitude when I tell you I got an emergency?
Right.
Are you serious right now?
So, he told son, is my phone in your car? I guess if it ain't with you, it must be in the car. So, he goes out to the car, comes back. Can I see your phone? Okay. But then go walk out the restaurant. Dude, why are you going with my phone? So, he comes back into the restaurant, hands me my phone. And then, he's questioning people in the line, taking their receipts. And then going back to the counter and saying, hey, is this order up yet? And I'm like, the people in line is actually appreciating it. I'm like, is this a Thrones Firebird people? Yeah. People, I don't have nothing against y'all. I had nothing against y'all, but how are you in agreement with somebody who seems to be off their rocker? I'm trying to figure that out.
They just seemed like it was okay.
It seemed like there was like 3-4 people that was like in agreement with him.
Oh.
I'm like, okay, that's just like weird. But we get in the car. Next thing I know, he was like, he run me down to Applebee's.
Did you order more food? Is that what I need in my phone?
I take him to Applebee's. Child, he seriously comes out the restaurant with nothing but one fry that he done put in his mouth.
What? What the hell? What kind of people are you hanging up with?
So we leave Applebee's. I need directions back to his house because I don't know where he lives.
Travis said, it's Spartanburg. What you
look? Like I said, I leave Applebee's. I need directions to his house.
West side.
Look, we driving. I'm thinking this man is taking me back to his house so I can drop him off and hightail it. Take this turn. Take that turn. Right here. Dude, this ain't where I picked you up from. This the liquor house.
Oh!
Wait a minute. The liquor house. And then instead of him just getting out the car and going to get the liquor, he's sitting there talking. So some man up here in the door, I said, is he bringing it to you? Oh, no. Hey, Ernie.
Tell the dude that for real.
I'm like, hey, Ernie. And gets out the car.
I was going to be the fly on the window, okay?
I said, okay, the police watch liquor houses, drug houses, and prostitution houses, stuff like this. If my darn car get pulled over, I know something. I'm giving it all up. He going to jail. Okay. I'm not going down with this man for nothing. So, we ended up leaving there. I'm trying to floor this car. Like, I'm trying to whip it around and everything. We finally get to his house. Like I said, I'm flooring it. So, I end up bypassing his house.
Oh, dang.
So, I whip it into the gas station. He said, oh, no, I want to come here anyways. I want to talk to her, who's the teller inside. But instead of him just get out the car, he is still running his mouth. So I was like, I didn't interrupt him. I said, so was you like going to talk to her or say hey or something? Or what's up to take you home? I'm going to stay up here. I'm going to talk to her. Oh, okay. Well, don't drink all the alcohol and then walk home. I was there right there. I'm still trying to be nice. I'm still trying to be, you know, cordial and everything. Dude, you already drunk a whole bottle of, you know, whiskey or whatever that you had the first time. You don't need to drink that whole bottle and then walk home. It's still like drinking and driving, you know, where you're impaired.
Yeah.
So you don't need to drink that whole bottle and then walk home. So.
Exactly. You was the Uber driver. That's what it sounds like to me.
Look.
He didn't need somebody so he can get around with.
Like, but he said he was cold. So, you know, like I was trying to be nice. And I gave the man, I let the man use my coat.
Tamara said that.
So, he said, I said, you know, you can keep the coat. Keep the coat. I'll get it back later. I call one of my best friends.
Public intoxication.
Look, I call my. He said the girl who was inside lived in the same community. And I said, is she going to walk home with you? No. I said, okay, look. Like I said, don't drink the whole bottle and walk home. She's not going to walk home with you.
Yeah.
So after I left, I called one of my best friends who lives in the same area. I didn't know his address. I said, hey, I'm in your area. I said, what's your address? I be darn. They lived on the same goddamn road.
Dang.
They lived across the street from each other.
Dang.
I done told this man I got a whole emergency. So I'm on the highway and I turn have to go down a few S's and turn back around. I tell you, I ain't never passed a convenience store so fast in my life. You probably saw a blur.
Oh my God.
Remember that time we went to the Japanese restaurant and I dropped y'all off? And I said, all right, I'll see y'all later.
I got a head. I said, damn.
I said, my head
said, I said, tipping in his head is popping right there.
That's how my head was in the ceiling.
I said, dang, honey.
Because I ended up, because I thought it was the exact same apartment complex, but apparently it was across the street. Because I just assumed when I seen the road that it was the exact same place.
Yes.
Because I realized there was apartments across the street. And I ain't going to lie. I had said, oh, he lives in the, I said, he lives in the bad looking ones. I said, oh, you live in the nice ones. And he said, oh, yeah, the ones across the street is the ghetto.
Damn.
I said, you ain't lying. Those are the ghetto.
Poor thing, you okay? Have you had a date ever since then?
Like Monique.
Oh, okay. You gotta show me what. Do you have a picture of him? You gotta show me what he looks like. Oh my God. I gotta see. I don't wanna see it right now. I don't wanna see it right after the show. I don't wanna see it right now. Because I gotta see this. Oh my goodness. That's just like so out of your lane. Jeez, poor thing.
He could talk the talk, but he sure as heck couldn't walk the walk.
Aw. Well, you guys, it was great chilling with y'all tonight. We're going to definitely do it again next week.
Remember, that will be on next Tuesday, all right?
Tuesdays. Absolutely. So make sure you guys tune in. But you know what, though? Like, but what time Tuesdays? Because you work, right?
Yes, it will be in the 9 or 10 o'clock hour on Tuesdays, okay?
Because we got to start keeping a set schedule. Because yes. I know our schedule has been, like, kind of off for a minute.
Exactly, we're going to get back into this rotation.
We'll get back in. Season 3 is still going strong, but we just ain't getting started. Right. Hello? But yes, but make sure you guys rewatch the video. Make sure you guys share. Make sure you guys comment below your thoughts on the topics at hand.
Exactly.
We had plenty of more topics to talk about, but unfortunately,
we're out of time.
Exactly. And it's always great when we get together.
Exactly.
It's always
great. Make sure you send in those topics and those emails to the LDShow2017@gmail.com. And for those of you on YouTube, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that bell. All yes. Right.
And our channel is Lala and Devante.
That's L-A-L-A with a space in between Lala's.
Those Lala's.
Those Lala's.
Whatever. Sit down. But yes, it was great chilling with you tonight. It was great chilling with y'all tonight. old times, and I have missed it. I have missed it so much. Make sure you guys catch the premiere on YouTube. This, when is it
going to be? This Wednesday.
It'll be this Wednesday.
We'll be going. Actually, it'd be kind of not strange, but it'd be kind of be a lot to deal with for y'all, I guess, because you'll see a new show and then it'll be a premiere. You're going to see a new show on Tuesday, but then it's going to be a premiere for this show on Wednesday, and then it'll be another new show on
Friday.
It'll be another premiere on that Friday.
Because we're changing up. So.
Yes.
Look at us, honey. Hey.
It's going to be a lot for y'all, so y'all make sure y'all keep it all, you know, all organized, and we'll make sure y'all are reminded. Yes. So.
And we have some people that's coming to the show as well.
Yes.
As guest co-hosts.
Some guest co-hosts is coming up, so yes. We'll make sure we keep y'all reminded with that, so make sure you stay tuned on our Facebook page, you know, Lala and Devante, the L&D show, so.
Yes, honey. Well, I'm finna get out this good wig, honey. It's hot in the mud and drinking too.
As soon as the camera's gone, she gonna do one of these. She's gonna go for a line.
Like Cynthia did.
You seen that? Did you see that? She was like, "Are you wanna see?"
I saw that. I said, "Cynthia."
She just threw it off. I said, "Ooh."
But hey, sometimes you gotta do that, though, honey. But yes, honey, yes. But thank y'all so much for watching tonight. We love you guys. And we will see you guys next time. I'm Lala.
Devante.
Bye.
Wait. Before you go anywhere,
make sure you subscribe to our channel.
Make sure you click that bell.
Make sure you comment.
And make sure you like and share all of our videos in that order.
Okay.
Thanks for watching. Put your hands up in the air.